Bruce used his superior strategy to counter any wave of English attack. Although vastly outnumbered, he lured Edward's army into the marshy section of the battlefield, where they could not retaliate with full mobility. The battle raged on. The Highlanders could see victory only a short grasp away, but the English would not give up the struggle. Bruce needed an extra input of manpower, some support he had previously been promised and not materialized, and his annoyance was evident in the ferocity of his command. But help did arrive. From the Isles poured thousands of Highlanders, headed by Rory MacLeod, under the leadership of Angus Hogg, then Lord of the Isles. The Scots took heart, even the non-fighting folk, the baggage carriers, servants and priests, flung themselves in at the strategic moment. Though Bruce's superb generalship never faltered, Edward saw defeat looming and fled the battlefield. The Battle of Bannockburn became Scotland's greatest victory, the turning point in Scotland's fight for freedom. 14 years of battle and adventure were to pass before the peace treaty of 1328 was signed. After Bannockburn, it was safe for Rory to return and claim his bride. But during the rest of his life, he continued to fight by Bruce's side. But that's another story.
Summon to my call.